3D computer graphics uses an interesting concept to speed up object display called backface culling. Imagine you're looking at a box. Here's the side view in 2D. Only the sides of the box that face toward you are visible. The back faces here and here do not need to be rendered. The fastest polygon to render is the one you don't ever have to render at all. Backface culling can throw away about half the faces in an object, so it's a worthwhile optimization. For example, here's a real live box. If you look at it from any angle, you're only going to see a few of the faces of the whole box, and the rest of the faces can be thrown away. Backfaces can be culled for any solid object. This V-shape seen from the side has only two sides facing towards the camera, outlined in green. These other two faces can be thrown away without further processing. It turns out this green face here is hidden from view by this front face, but we let the Z-buffer take care of hiding that. We can set whether backface culling is enabled or disabled, but how do we determine if a triangle is a front face or a back face? There are just three points defining each triangle, and there's no flag stored for additional information. What determines front or back facing is the order of the vertices after they're projected onto the screen. In WebGL, if the order is counterclockwise, the triangle's front facing. If it's clockwise, it's back facing. Going counterclockwise like this is often called the right hand rule. The fingers of your right hand wrap around the edges of the triangle in order. If your thumb points at you, the triangle is then front facing.